Get it up!
Come on!
Dominate!
All three!
One, two, three!
Dominate! Woo!
Younger kids, I thought I was really impressed with they came out and played that hard. They knew they had a chance to play in front of a crowd under the lights. So our older kids executed well, and our young kids got a chance to play.
How do you keep this going when you win by such large margins? 42-0, 54-0 tonight. How do you keep the confidence and the ball rolling forward?
Let me tell you something. They're probably the most important people on the team are those five offensive interior linemen.
Party, we will party hard. every game we look to improve on our play, get better every practice, and step it up every time we step on the football field.
Our second string is just basically as good as our first string, and we just got basically two first teams going at it at practice, just making each other better every day, and we're just working hard, just keeping it going.
One, two, three.
They've been a real good football team for the last 8 weeks. And when you're only averaging giving up 1 point per game, you know, that's, I don't think there's too many teams around here have done that in 8 games. In fact, I've been around here about 40 years in coaching, and I really don't know of any team that only gave up 9 points in their first 8 games. That's really something terrific.
My mama said, Well, they proved they're human, giving up six, but Northern Lehigh kicked it up a couple notches in the second half. They improved to 9-0 and proved they can't be beat, and they won't be beat with the 45-6 win. They also clinched at least a share of the Colonial League titles.
It's really exciting. I mean, what a group of kids, and, you know, they hung in. Kagg did a nice job. They really did, and hung in there for a half, and then talked to the kids at halftime. There was no smashing boards or carrying on. We just settled them down and said, hey, we gotta get our things together. So we're just excited and blessed to be able to clinch at least a tie for another championship.
Excerpts tonight. Back on, I'll take you on. Headstrong to take on anyone. I know that you are wrong. Headstrong, we're headstrong. Back on, I'll take you on. Headstrong to take on anyone. I know that you are wrong. And this is not when you belong.
Gave us a heck of a lot of problems. 59 is one heck of a player from Northwestern. He is something special. And it was giving us some problems. We get in at halftime. The kids gave the pep talk. We looked at where we thought we could take a poke, and it worked out. And Surface just wasn't going to be stopped. That's kind of back he is. So just very, very grateful that I could be along for the ride with this bunch of kids.
You've got to do the job in the trenches, and we had trouble with them, and then turning the football over on top of that, you just can't give them that many opportunities with all of the talent that they have and as good as they are. We wish them the best, and hopefully we get the opportunity to watch them at Hershey.
And they always say defense wins championships. They proved it. I mean, they also had a lot of offense. Yeah. I mean, they scored only 400 50. Points or something on the season. Yeah, but it's nice when you only have to score three to win every game.
The Dogs won. Dogs are won.
Hershey, baby.
Hey, can you believe it? They came in here screaming mercy rule. Okay? I showed them a couple things. I'm really proud of it. It's you guys. You guys did this. You guys did this. Nobody else did.
Coming out of the East undefeated, a 14-0 for their first ever championship game appearance. Aliquippa coming for the fourth time, looking to win it for the first time since they were a AAA entry in 1991.
Running that fast. Fact of the matter is, as we've seen three times today, he sure is.
Revis, he's just going to keep it himself, has the first down, and look out, he's headed the outside. Revis in a foot race. Surface, last man to get him, can't do it. Revis, touchdown! 64 yards, Darrell Revis.
I guess the biggest thing now is that I miss the day-to-day contact with these kids. And I think part of the reason that they were so good is because of the kind of people they were. I miss the interaction with them. I wish I still had them every day. While we were going through it, I really think I was able to enjoy it. I think some college coaches are clueless because they look too much at size and they don't look enough at some kids in regard to their heart and their leadership and their toughness. And now I appreciate how physically tough they were. I look back at the Lakeland game and I see bodies flying all over the field and our kids just getting up and smiling. I remember the practices where we had to pull them off each other because they were too physical. But I remember a bunch of gentlemen, and that's the thing that hits home most, is how great they were as individuals, how much fun we had, you know, and we laughed more than we ever cried. And I think that was the key. And a bunch of parents were extremely supportive in a great year, and how unselfish this group was. Nobody cared who scored. Nobody cared who got the carries. Let's just try to do the best we can to win and get better every day. When they talk about the future of our football program, you can't measure it in terms of wins. I think you're going to measure is, can we get another group together like this of young men who will play for each other, play for the community, and play hard for their coaches like this and not care about any outside influences. It's just amazing to be associated with kids like this, and I think it was high school football at its best and at its purest form.